This video shows how to follow up a non-significant interaction in a mixed ANOVA in R. If you have a significant interaction effect, however, please look at the video in the info cards. This video focuses on investigating the main effects. Of course, you need a low enough p-value in the mixed ANOVA to justify doing the following. I will now pretend for the sake of this video that my interaction effect is not significant, and I will look at the two main effects. I'll start with the between subject effect, aka the group effect. The main effects can be investigated by simply looking at the ANOVA underscore test results from the mixed ANOVA itself. Again, please ignore the significant interaction effect for the sake of this video. I can observe a significant between subject effect with a low enough p-value. This implies a group difference, disregarding the existence, or rather combination, with different measures over time. With the help of, for example, a line graph, you can see that the test variable for one group might be higher for a certain amount of time or even the whole time. A significant main effect can always be followed up with pairwise post hoc tests, like you would do in an ordinary one-way ANOVA. Even though I have only two groups, I will still show the calculation. Use piping on your data frame and the pairwise underscore t underscore test function. Put your test variable first, then tilde, then your group variable. Don't forget the p-adjust method when you have more than two groups to counter alpha error inflation. In your results, look at the adjusted p-value to determine group differences. The second main effect is the within subject effect. Since I violated sphericity, I need to look at the sphericity corrected results below for the within subject effect. I see a significant within subject effect, aka a difference over time. I can also follow this up with pairwise t-tests. This time, my formula consists of the test variable and the time variable. Don't forget the paired equals true argument to indicate that you have repeated measures for your groups. As usual, the p-value adjustment is added. In my example, I can only observe one low enough p-value between t0 and t4. Depending on your data, this might be driven by only one or even multiple groups. Only a significant interaction allows for further differentiation though, leaving you with rather general conclusions now. Looking at the development of your means or an additional graph might reveal trends, but no hard evidence. Most of the time, the effect that may exist in reality can only be observed with a larger sample size. Other limitations to your study may of course exist and should be discussed. After investigating the main effects, I can continue reporting my results or calculate the effect size for the mixed ANOVA itself, which is optional.